Welcome to today's video. I'm just going to be running you through a very simple tutorial, and the tutorial is how to implement a progress indicator, so a loading view, in a SwiftUI project. So let's just jump right in. Okay, so the first thing we're going to have to do is select the app as the project type. So the next thing we're going to want to do is set the project details. And so we're just going to call this progress, and you make sure that your interface is SwiftUI. The lifecycle is set as SwiftUI app. The language set to Swift, and make sure that these two checkboxes at the bottom are unchecked. We're not going to be using them. So you just want to make sure you save your project to wherever on your computer you would like to save the project to. And once it's opened up, we're going to take sure that the right pane, that the preview window is open, working. So you'll see here that I have mine working. I'm just going to get it into a view where we can all see. So the first thing we're going to want to do is create a new file. So you can either do it by right-clicking or pressing Command N. So now we have to select the file type, and we're going to make it a Swift file and click Next. And then we have to give it a name, and we're going to call ours Activity Indicator View, just so that we know what this file does. It's very important for project organization. The first thing I'm going to do is import SwiftUI, and that's going to become important because we're going to be using some things linked to SwiftUI. And so we're going to start by creating our first struct, which is we're going to call Activity Indicator, and we're going to make it of type UI View Representable. Now, give us some space, and you'll see in a minute that there's an error that's going to pop up. And essentially, this error is saying that the UI Activity Indicator doesn't conform to the protocol UI View Representable. Now, that's not an issue. By the time we finish creating this struct, it will conform. So right now, for right now, you can ignore that error. And we're just gonna, just ignore the error. We'll get it fixed in a minute. And so the first thing I want to do is create a type alias of type UI view type, and we're going to make that equal to our UI activity indicator view. And that's essentially a view that we're pulling from UIKit. And we're going to let the style of UI activity indicator view dot style, and that's going to come again when we set the style. So for right now, just follow along. So now the two functions that we need to add to make this conform to the protocol is make view and update view. Once we have those views in, you'll see that the error goes away. Those are the functions required to make this conform to that protocol. So we're going to do a couple changes to both functions. And our first change is to the make view. And so the first thing we're going to do is change the context to UI view representable. And in between the tags, we're going to add activity indicator. So that's our first change. Our second change is then to append UI view type to the back of our UI activity indicator. And here I made two errors. So for the first one, you need to add the word context to the end, and you need to remove UI from the return. And then simply we're just going to return, made an error there. We're just going to return our UI activity indicator view, and we're going to set the style to style. For the update UI view function, we're going to make some changes here as well. And so the first change we need is to append UI view type to the first part and change the context to UI view representable representable context, and within the tags add activity indicator. And so here I made another error, and we're going to just take a look and read what that is, and it's just cannot find type, and that's because there is no type of that type. So we're just going to remove the UI from activity indicator, and that should make everything perfect. And then all we got to do is add UI view dot start animating into this function call, and that's it. And that's our first struct completed. Okay, so just a quick break here. Be sure to subscribe for future content, and so that I can get more stuff out that you guys want to see. So we're just going to jump into the next thing, and that's just creating a struct. And this struct is the activity indicator view. And so essentially, this is just a SwiftUI view. So you could make this in its own separate SwiftUI file, but just to have everything in one place in regards to our activity indicator, we're going to do it here. And so here you just see me kind of building out the skeleton of that view. Press enter a couple times here to give us some more space. Jumping right in, we're going to create an app binding variable So we're going to hear, as you see here, at binding variable, we're going to call it is displayed, and we're going to make it of type bool. Like mentioned, this is essentially just a Swift UI view. So you could just use the new file type and set a new view. But for the sake of this tutorial and to make sure that everything is in one place, I'm just adding it here to the bottom. And so I'm just building out the requirements needed to make this a Swift UI view. The first thing we want to put in the view is a geometry reader. There it is. And open and close brackets. And then at the top there, we're going to add geometry in. Adding a Z stack here. And we're going to set its alignment and content. And so we're going to set alignment to dot center. And the content, we're going to make it an if block. So if self dot is displayed, and that's the variable we created earlier. Yeah, so if self dot is displayed is false, we're going to sell, then we want self dot content. Where else, if it's true, we're going to have the same self dot content, but now we're going to modify it a bit with some modifiers. Okay, and our first modifier is going to, we're going to set disabled to true. And so that's basically, we want the content on the screen to not be interactable, as the loading indicator is showing. We're going to set the blur of the content, so everything behind our indicator. I just chose 3. Feel free to choose anything you want here. And so this is me looking because I see the errors and I'm trying to figure out where I messed up. And there's my first mess up, is that was supposed to be content, not context. Okay, and so we're just going to continue. And so yeah, we had our disabled set to true, and we had our blur set to a radius of 3. And that's essentially our if block. Okay, also in this else section, we're gonna create the loading indicator itself. So basically, when the loading indicator is shown, we want the content below to be disabled, and we want the and it to be blurred. And but on top of that, we want to add a loading indicator, and so we're going to create that view here. And so we have it as a V stack. We're going to set the text to loading. You can set it to whatever you want, and we're going to throw in our activity indicator, which we created above, and we're going to set its style to dot large. And so just some simple modifiers on this. We're going to add a frame modifier so we can set the width and height of the view itself. And first is the width, and we're going to set the width to be essentially half the height of the screen, or half the width of the screen, sorry. And so how we do that is we do geometry.size.width divided by 2. And we're going to set the height to a set value of 200. Now, you can change this and have it be whatever size you want, so feel free to play around. And the next thing we have to do is change the background. And so we're going to have the background color to be color.secondary and invert it. Now, again, this is, you can choose this to be whatever you want, any color you want. And then the foreground color, we're going to have color.primary. Again, set that to whatever color you want if you don't like the ones I'm using. And we're going to give it a corner radius of 20. And with that, we're completely done this activity indicator view file. So we've done everything we've needed to do here, and now we can move on to implementing it. And where we're going to implement that is into a view. And so in this instance, we're going to use a content view. Now again, if your project is bigger, find out which view you want to implement it on and go there. And so here's our Swift UI view, bare bones, as we got it when we started the project. Okay, so this view doesn't come clean, and so we're basically going to remove the text component that is already given to us when you open a new Swift UI view. Starting with a clean slate, we're going to first start with a V stack, and inside our V stack, we're going to put in a button. And this button needs the action label options, and so right now our actions is blank, so the button does nothing when clicked. But the label button, you know what, that's fine. That's actually perfectly fine. You can have that be anything you want, but for the sake of this tutorial, we'll just leave it a button. Adding our first modifier, we're going to do a frame modifier and give it a width and height. And so we're going to do a width of, let's say, 200 and a height of 50. Again, those are arbitrary. You can choose whatever options you want there. We're going to make our button foreground color white, so that's the text, and we're going to do a background color of blue. Again, choose whatever colors you like. I really don't like the square options of buttons. It kind of reminds me of like outdated app. So we're just going to add a corner radius of 5. Actually, no, 5 isn't big enough. Let's do 15. And that'll just give us the iOS style kind of rounded button that we all know and love. Okay, so great. We have this button. Right now it doesn't do anything, but the label and the text is there. Now, so I created this button because I want to be able to control our activity indicator popping up on the screen. And so we're going to create a new function. Now, we could do this just in the button action section itself, but let's do it properly and let's do it in its own separate function. And so we're going to create a new variable and we're going to call it loading toggle, and we're going to set it to false. Probably not the best name, but it'll work for now. And we're going in the function that we created below, toggle loading, we're going to essentially toggle that variable. Oh, I have an error here. Expected an argument. Oh, I see it now. I missed the parentheses after the toggle loading. There we go. So just add the parentheses, make a space. Hopefully you didn't make the same mistake I did. And I have another error, and this time it's self. Okay, so you just remove self. You don't need it in this instance. Well, another error. Let's see. Cannot use mutating member on immutable value. Oh, I know what this is. Okay, so I need to make this, I need to change my variable at the top here and make it an @state variable. And that should remove the error. Yes, it does, and we're good to go. All right, I know I said that we would have a separate function, but we're gonna remove this here for now. And we're actually just gonna do it in the button itself. But the next thing we need to do, so right now we have our button in place, but there's something else we need on the screen. And that's essentially the activity indicator. So we're gonna add our activity indicator view and we're gonna set its variables. So we're gonna set isDisplayed to loading toggle, which is the Boolean variable that we created above the view. And for content, if we just click enter here, and so this is what would be displayed underneath the activity indicator view. And just for simplicity, we're gonna make that a text view, and we're just going to make it a blank text. Now, you could again have that be more content, a text box that says something else. That's completely up to you. And so now we are just checking on the preview, and the button doesn't do anything, and that's because we forgot to add what we want our button to do. So in this button section, we're just going to call loading toggle dot toggle, and that essentially just flips the variable from one to the other. Jumping back to the preview, we're just gonna run it, and if we click button, we'll see that, oh great, there's our loading indicator in action. And when we click it again, it disappears. Click it again, and it's back on screen. Now, typically, you wouldn't have this being controlled by a button. So if there's some action or in your app that requires a lot of time, like downloading information or uploading information to your database or the cloud or wherever, you would want to kind of freeze the app so that the user can't do anything that would hinder that. But then you also don't want them to think that the app just crashed. So if you have areas in your app where that would make sense, where such a system would make sense, you'd want to use something like what we developed here, which is a loading activity indicator. And so that's the project. That's it. So using these steps, you can implement an activity indicator view in any project that you want. Thank you for tuning in. This has been real great. Don't forget to like and subscribe. And of course, drop what you want to learn next in the comments, and I'll try my best to get that out to you guys.